Hi, we're here today to talk about what to do when I have an unbalanced three-phase load and how that affects my power and what happens with my power. So a quick video today, and it's a pretty straightforward process for what we need to understand. But what I've got here is a three-phase 600 volt source, line A, line B, line C. Doesn't matter if it's Y or Delta. We're not going to have a neutral in this case, but you could, of course. And it's the same process whether you're Delta or whether you're Y loads. In this video, we're going to do a Delta load, and maybe down the road, I'll do another video with a Y load and we can take a look at that. So what I want to do here is, let's say on phase A, so from A, I'm going to connect down to a resistor, and that's going to go back up to B. And let's say this is a 1200 watt resistor. Then in phase B, so going from B to C, I'm going to put a coil with a resistive value. That's from B to C, right? So a dirty coil or a real world coil. And let's say it's 1200 VA with a power factor of 0.7. Then lastly, on phase C, so going from C to A, I'm going to put a capacitor, which is 600 vars, right? So essentially what we've connected here, and I'm just, is we've connected something, and the circuit kind of looks like this, you know, from A to B, I've got my resistor. From B, right, node, to C is where I've got that coil. And then from C to A is where I've got that cap, right? So it kind of looks something like that. Those are connected in Delta, those three loads across each phase. I'm seeing that 600 volts, and they all have their line current and their phase current as well, which we're not going to get into in this video. But what I want to do here is, obviously, first thing I want to do is I'm going to break down the B phase. So this is already in watts. I want to find my power triangle essentially for this. So if I've got that and it's 0.7 is my power factor and I am 1200 VA, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my 1200 VA, multiply it by my power factor, and that's going to give me the power here of 840 watts. Now the other one I want to look at is phase C. And I want to figure out my watts here. Well, if I've got 600 var, that means I've got 600 VA. Because the capacitor is pure, there is no watts. Well, that's going to be 0 watts. So break down each phase individually. What do we have in those loads? And of course, we could take this down to current and impedance, but we're not going to. But for power, three-phase power in an unbalanced load. And this is the key right here. Three-phase power in an unbalanced load. P three phase equals the power of phase A plus the power of phase B plus the power of phase C. So in this case, it would be A to B is phase A, B to C is phase B, and C to A is phase C. That's the calculation. This right here is all you came to this video for. How do we calculate the power in a three-phase unbalanced? A to B plus B to C plus C to A. So in our case, we would be 1200 watts plus 840 watts plus 0 watts. So at the end of the day, our calculation comes out to, oh, I didn't even write it down, 2040 watts. That's how you would calculate the three-phase power in an unbalanced load. So again, check out my other video for a Y connection. Make sure you take a look at all of my three-phase power videos. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe, throw something in the comments, tell me what else you want to see, and have an awesome day. Thanks again for watching.